Hi everyone, welcome, and let's start with Introduction to Economics and Statistics, Part 1. My name is Ms. Karishma Kapoor, and before I begin, I would recommend all of you to study newspapers every day. It's very important. Make it a habit to just take out 1 hour, and study newspapers, and it will be helpful for you in future. So let's begin. Now, why do we study economics? Whenever you study any subject, you know, you should ask yourself that why I am studying this subject? What is the importance of it? Right? So the term economics is derived from the Greek word oikonomia. Oiko means household and nomia means management. So oikonomia means household management. Alright. So suppose I get rupees 100 as a pocket money, and my mother says that, all right Karishma, take this rupees 100 and buy anything you want to buy. Now I have a lot of choices, I can buy a lot of things, so there I have to make a choice, right? Similar thing apply to an economy. Now in an economy we have limited resources and our wants are unlimited. Now this creates a problem of choice. Now that is why we study economics, alright? Now, before I begin to explain you the certain concepts of economics, let me just begin with the blueprint of class 11th economics. Now, as you can see part A, alright? Part A is statistics for economics. We'll be having two books. One, statistics for economics, and another one, introductory microeconomics. Now statistics is of 40 marks. Similarly, microeconomics is of 40 marks. So 40 plus 40 makes it 80. So theory marks 80, and you have to submit one project also, that is of 20 marks. So 80 plus 20 is 100. Now what we will learn in statistics is that in statistics what we do is we collect data, we organize it, we present it, and finally we analyze the data to draw meaningful conclusions from it. Alright. Now part B is introductory microeconomics. Now microeconomics is a part of economics in a sense that economics has two branches. One is microeconomics, another one is macroeconomics. Now microeconomics you will study in class 11th, macroeconomics you will study in class 12th. Now what is microeconomics? Microeconomics is when you study an individual firm or an entity. That is known as microeconomics. I will explain you in detail afterwards. So let's go ahead. Alright. Now let's understand certain important terms and concepts of an economy. Alright. So first of all, what is an economy? Economy, it is a system which provides people the means to work and earn a living. Suppose I get out of my house, alright, main ghar se bahar jaati hoon, I see factories, I see shops, I see flyovers. Now all of the people are working there, right? So people who are employed, they get their wages. For example, if we go to factories, people are working and they're getting wages in return. So they are basically earning their living. So they are getting wages in order to support their family. They're getting their salary in order to support their family. Similarly, people in factory, they're also producing goods and services which are consumed by us. Wo log jo manufacture karte hain, wo hum consume karte hain. So, and also they get a living for it. They get a salary for it. So all these economic institutions taken together is called an economy, which is why it is written means to work and earn a living. Now let's come to the next term, which is scarcity. It refers to the limitation of supply in relation to demand for a commodity. It basically means when demand is more as compared to its supply. Say for example, due to COVID-19, coronavirus, now the demand for masks have increased tremendously, whereas the supply is limited, alright, which is why we have to export from other countries. So that is, so what we see, we have a scarcity of mask. Now let's come to the next point, which is resources versus human wants. Now let's see the first box right here, human wants. human wants have two characteristics. One, human wants are unlimited. Our desires are unlimited. आज मम्मी को बोला मुझे साइकिल चाहिए, कल मम्मी को बोला मुझे स्कूटी चाहिए, परसों मम्मी को बोला मुझे कार चाहिए. सो आर डिज़ायर्स आर वॉन्ट्स आर एक्सपैंडिंग एक्सपोनेंशियली. ऑलराइट, सो आर वॉन्ट्स आर अनलिमिटेड, डिज़ायर्स नेवर एंड. दैट इज़ नंबर वन कैरेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ वॉन्ट्स. नंबर टू, दे डिफर इन प्रायोरिटी इन अ सेंस दैट सम वॉन्ट्स आर वेरी अर्जेंट, आई वॉन्ट इट राइट नाउ, बट सम वॉन्ट्स कैन बी पोस्टपोन्ड. सो वॉन्ट्स के दो कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स, वन दे आर अनलिमिटेड एंड नंबर टू दे डिफर इन प्रायोरिटी. नाउ लेट्स कम टू द सेकेंड बॉक्स विच इज रिसोर्सेज. नाउ वी ऑल नो दैट आर दैट इन एन इकोनमी रिसोर्सेज आर लिमिटेड, नंबर वन. एंड ऑल्सो नंबर टू कैरेक्टरिस्टिक इज दैट इट कैन बी पुट इन टू ऑल्टरनेटिव यूजेस. वॉट डज दिस मीन? आई एक्सप्लेन यू विद द हेल्प ऑफ एन एग्जाम्पल. से पेट्रोल, तेल, ठीक है ना. पेट्रोल इज यूज इन आर कार्स, पेट्रोल इज यूज इन इंजन्स, पेट्रोल इज यूज इन मशीन्स, पेट्रोल इज यूज इन एयरप्लेन्स. कहाँ 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 यूज होता है, कितने सारी जगहों में यूज होता है. अब देयर इज अ प्रॉब्लम ऑफ चॉइस. ऑलरेडी पेट्रोल इज स्केर्स. नाउ विद दिस स्केर्स पेट्रोल हमको सारी चीज़ों को सेटिस्फाई करना है, राइट? सो दैट इज अ प्रॉब्लम ऑफ चॉइस. नाउ वी हैव गॉट द क्रक्स. Resources, they are limited and they can be put into alternative uses, for example petrol, right? Now these two points makes a conclusion for us that there is a problem of choice. Why? Because our resources are limited, on the other hand our wants are unlimited. तो हमको choose तो करना पड़ेगा. अगर mom ने मुझे 100 rupees दिए और मेरा वो limited budget है, मुझे उसी limited budget में choose करना पड़ेगा कि मुझे क्या क्या चीज़ें खरीदनी है. Alright, so that creates a problem of choice, and that is why we have this economic problem. Alright, now let's continue with the same concept, economic problem. Economic problem is a problem of choice. As I've explained to you earlier that it is a problem of choice. Why? Because we need to satisfy unlimited wants out of limited resources. Can you see the seesaw? This seesaw, right? Bachpan mein khelte the. So, our wants are unlimited. On the other hand, we have limited resources. So, we need to actually maintain a balance between these two. And for that, the study of economics is very important. Alright? Now, let's come to the next point, which is we need to classify between two activities. One is the economic activity and the other one is non-economic activities. Now, what are economic activities? Activities undertaken for a monetary gain. All right. Suppose we teachers go to school, right? And we get salary for it, right? So we are earning a salary. We are teaching. Obviously, it's our passion also, but then we are also teaching for a monetary gain, right? So these are the activities which are undertaken for a monetary gain. Now, under it, we have five important economic activities. Number one is production. Production is the process of converting raw materials into finished products, right? For example, a cloth. A cloth is a raw material, and when I manufacture it to a shirt, then it is a finished product. So this process of conversion of cloth to shirt is the process of production, right? Now, who is a producer? A producer is the one who produces that shirt and sells in the market at a predetermined price. This was production. What is a consumption? Consumption is the process of consuming certain goods and services for the satisfaction of wants. So for a consumer, his goal is that his wants should be satisfied. Jo uske desires hain, that should be satisfied. On the other hand, producer ka kya role hota hai? Producer's goal is to maximize profits. Usko to apne profits maximize karne, alright? Now, investment. What is an investment? Investment is the buying of a capital asset which will create future income for me. Say for example, मैंने एक कार खरीदी और उस कार को अब मैं as a cab use करती हूँ. तो ये कार मेरे लिए एक kind of asset है. क्यों? क्योंकि मैं अब cab को use करके I'll be earning income, right? So that buying of that car was a kind of investment for me, right? Now that is investment. Fourth point is exchange. Exchange is the buying and selling of a commodities at a predetermined price, all right? Distribution. Distribution is how I distribute my income. Say for example, I am the CEO of Apple company, right? I've got my income, I've got the profits. Now I have to distribute that among my subordinates, right? So that is distribution. Now let's come to non-economic activities. Activities which are not concerned with monetary gain. Jo main apni marzi se kar rahi hun. For example, agar main charity karti hun, ya fir main koi religious activity mein jaati hun. So that is non-economic activity. So let's move forward. So now I can explain that what is economics. So economics is all about making choices in the presence of scarcity, as explained below, and then it is a study of how to allocate scarce resources in such a way so that consumers ko bhi satisfaction mile, producers ko bhi profit maximization ho, or society ko bhi social welfare ho. So we really need to make choices in the presence of scarcity of resources. Isko karne ke liye economics ko samajhna bahut zyada zaruri hai. As I've told earlier, economics has two branches, micro and macro. Alright, micro talks about individual economic units. Macro talks about economy as a whole. Isko aise samjhenge. For example, there is one firm A in Delhi which is producing Colgate, right? Agar main usi firm A in Delhi ko study karungi, to wo ho gaya microeconomics. Agar main baki n number of firms jo different states mein hai, usko bhi study karungi, which is producing Colgate only, mind it, I am only talking about the commodity Colgate, alright? तो अगर एक फॉर्म की बात करूं जो दिल्ली में है उसको स्टडी करूंगी तो हो गया माइक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स. ऐसी बहुत सारी फॉर्म्स होंगी ऑल ओवर इंडिया जो कोलगेट प्रोड्यूस करेंगी. सो जब द क्लस्टर ऑफ ऑल द फॉर्म्स विच इज प्रोड्यूसिंग द सेम कमोडिटी दैट इज कोलगेट, देन इट इज कॉल्ड मैक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स, राइट? सो इफ यू कैन सी, माइक्रो का आई स्टैंड्स फॉर इंडिविजुअल इकोनॉमिक यूनिट्स, मैक्रो का ए स्टैंड्स फॉर एग्रीगेट्स. सो माइक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स, जब मैं एक छोटे हाउस होल्ड या फर्म की बात करूँ तो माइक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स, मैक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स जब मैं पूरे इकोनॉमी एज अ होल की बात करूँ, दैट इज माइक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स. सो लेट्स मूव फॉरवर्ड. नाउ दिस इज अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग क्वेश्चन. व्हेन आई वॉज अ स्टूडेंट आई हैड PCM, आई हैड साइंस, सो आई टुक इकोनॉमिक्स एज एन optional subject, alright? So I have this in my mind that why school is offering me, I'm a science student, and why they're offering me economics as an optional subject. But after a few years I realized that economics cannot only be associated with arts or commerce stream, right? But it is a science as well. So we will understand this. So first, in order to understand that, we need to see what are the characteristics of science and what are the characteristics of arts, and we'll see if economics can be considered as both science and arts, right? So in science, we have systematic study of knowledge and facts. In science, we also develop correlation between cause and effect. Alright, we see which is the cause, we do experiments and see what was the cause and what is the effect. Third, laws are also universally accepted in science. For example, Newton's law of motion, right? The laws of science are universally accepted. All these three things are found in economics also. How come? Now, in both macro theories and micro theories, it involves systematic study of knowledge or facts, which are carefully analyzed in economics also. Economics also develops correlation between cause and effect. For example, law of demand. So if there is a change in price, which is the cause, there will be a change in demand, which is the effect. So you can see that there is a cause and effect relationship in economics also. Third, laws are universally accepted in economics as well. Say law of diminishing marginal utility, it is applicable. Law of demand. What is law of demand? If price of a commodity falls, the demand for that commodity increases, keeping other things constant. ये obviously बात है, ये law है. जो चेंज नहीं होता. ऑब्वियसली देर आर फ्यू एक्सेप्शंस, बट दिस इज अ लॉ विच इज यूनिवर्सली एक्सेप्टेड, राइट? सो वी कैन कंसिडर इकोनॉमिक्स एज अ साइंस. नाउ इकोनॉमिक्स एज अ साइंस कैन फर्दर बी डिवाइडेड इंटू टू पार्ट्स, पॉजिटिव साइंस एंड नॉर्मेटिव साइंस. पॉजिटिव साइंस इज थिंग्स एज दे आर, द फैक्ट्स, एंड नॉर्मेटिव साइंस इज थिंग्स एज दे ऑट टू बी. से आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू विद द हेल्प ऑफ एन एग्जाम्पल. से unemployment. So if I say unemployment rate is 5% in India, I am basically talking about positive signs. And when I say unemployment rate in India should be reduced, then it is normative signs. So right, when I'm actually telling you the fact that unemployment rate in India is 5%, I am talking about positive signs. When I'm saying that unemployment rate should be reduced, you know, then we are talking about normative science. Now, how is economics an art? The reason being, first, we should understand what are the characteristics of arts. Now, arts is basically practical application of knowledge. Now, whatever the principles, jo bhi principle science humko batata hai, jab hum usko practically world mein apply karte hain, tab wo arts kehlaya jata hai. Obviously, economics भी ये करता है. अगर मुझे economic theories आती हैं और मैं समझती हूँ economy को और मैं government की किसी organization में हूँ, तो I can recommend a policy maker कि ठीक है, आपको ये policies अपनी Indian economy में लानी चाहिए, right? So I am actually applying my knowledge to the real world, right? So hence, economics is a golden combination of both science and arts. All right. Now let's recapitulate what we have studied so far. We have studied significance of economics, that is why we should study economics. Second, basic concepts of economics. Thirdly, we understood the meaning of economics. And lastly, we discussed how economics is treated as both science and as an art, right? I hope you got all the points. Thank you so much.